Greetings from Kuchi Times. This is the weekly news update covering events from 24th to 31st May. My name is Moriro Akan. First, let's take a look at the week's top stories. Local Ugandan tabloid members Birmingham Pride Sex Fest. South African court hands lesbian killer two life sentences. Students drag Kenyan school to court. Turkish cleric says masturbation will lead to pregnant hands in the afterlife. Now the news in details. Local Ugandan tabloid labels Birmingham Pride Sex Fest. On 28 May, a local tabloid published pictures of LGBTI Ugandans celebrating Pride on its front page and labeled the event a sex fest. Activists from the Out and Proud Diamond group attended Birmingham Pride last weekend, only for pictures of the event to appear on the front page of the daily tabloid Hello headline, Uganda Gays Hold Sex Fest in UK. This is an isolated event, as there have been several publications in the past that have jumped at the opportunity to not only disgrace but also out LGBTI Ugandans. This goes to slow the mainstream media's conviction to continue outing sexual minorities even though they are well aware of their consequences that come with such acts. Kuchu Times condemns all acts that endanger the lives of people regardless of their sexual orientation and gender identity. South African court hands lesbian killer to life sentences. The Northwest High Court in Potchefstroom this week sentenced Christopher Pole Mathokwani to two life sentences for the murder of a lesbian disabled youth, Macau. Macau's mother shocked the world after her body was discovered near her home on August 15, 2014. She had been raped, strangled and had a hose pipe shoved down her throat into her stomach. During the trial, Macau's family members testified that they believed her death was a hate crime. They also welcomed the verdict with jubilation. Although it was clear that trauma from the ordeal would forever linger. Justice has been served. Macau never hurt anyone, and it was cruel for her to die the way she did. A family member was quoted saying after the court verdict had been read. The LGBTI community world over also received the news as a sign of victory for sexual minority rights. Mathokwani was also sentenced to 15 years behind bars for robbery. Students drug Kenyan school to court from neighboring Kenya, a case filled by five students who were expelled for allegedly engaging in lesbianism is now being heard before the High Court Judge Isaac Lonawawa. The students who were first suspended on April 8th prior to being expelled on May 18th by the Nairobi-based school then dragged the school's board of management through lawyer Mangombe Makeo. They claim that their expulsion is unconstitutional as it contravenes the Basic Education Act as well as the Children Act. They now want to be readmitted so that they can catch up with lost time and lessons, and also urge that both the suspension and expulsion were without a valid reason. Turkish cleric says masturbation would lead to pregnant hands in the afterlife from the crazy and wacky world. A Muslim cleric has caused an uproar across the globe after warning that masturbation could have unfathomable consequences in the aftermath. Mujahid Chahad Han, a Turkish television cleric, opined that men who masturbate will find their hands pregnant after crossing over to the next life. He based his statement on the fact that masturbation is forbidden in the Islamic faith, and to avoid such shame in the afterlife, all men should desist from the act. As we end this week's bulletin, we would like to remind you about a special share icon that we have incorporated on the site. People without any social media page can like the articles on the site by clicking the heart shape icon. Thank you for watching and have a wonderful week.
LGBTI.